He came to the length of the Civil War. He was shorter than the Revolutionary War, and longer than the War of 1812 and the War of 1848. About 618,000 Americans died in the Civil War. In comparison to the Revolutionary War, the War of 1812, and the War of 1848, a lot more people were killed in the Civil War. About 13,000 soldiers died or suffered injuries every month in the Civil War. About the number of men who died in the Mexican War, also known as the War of 1848. Most people think that the reason we resorted to the Civil War was slavery. However, it was a mixture of things, including nationalism. I think that between the economic and social differences of the North and South, the first was the federal right, the fight between the slaves and the non-slave people, the growth of the abolition movement and the election of Abraham Lincoln, the repeating fact of war not to be true again. The end of the Civil War was not just the end of slavery, as people think. The most African American was the back in the 1600s. The Civil War did not just end the war, but also brought the Japanese Jews to over 600,000 men.
Now the king told the boogeyman, you have to let that raga drop. The oil down the desert way has been shaken to the top.
Definition of freedom, the preservation of the Union, the fate of slavery, and the structure of our society and economy were all causes as well.
You can say that you love me now, in that way I can live without.
Hello, my name is Asia Alam Young, and I'll be teaching you a lesson in the American artistic movement, pop art. According to the American Heritage Dictionary of the English Language, the fourth edition, pop art is defined as a form of art that depicts objects or scenes from everyday life and employs techniques of commercial art and popular illustration. So what does that mean? Let's get into details. It was a visual art movement, pop art, that emerged in the 1950s and was popular in the 1960s in the United States. Some say that it started in Britain around the 1950s, but no one knows for sure. Pop art can be characterized by the themes and techniques drawn from popular mass culture, such as television, movies, advertising, and comic books. The common themes that we're seeing kind of throughout here, food, household objects, definitely easily recognizable objects, often even people from the popular mass culture. The pop artists like to satirize or ridicule objects, sometimes enlarging them to huge, gigantic proportions. These objects would often reflect mass culture and consumerism. And how these artists created a pop art piece? Well, this movement was usually marked by clear lines, sharp paintwork, and clear representations of symbols, objects, and people commonly found in popular culture. were the artists that created these wonderful works? Well, obviously, Andy Warhol here at the top left.
Now,
you are listening to Spoiler Alert Radio, all things film, locally and globally, podcasting at spoileralertradio.com. I am your host, Tony Panacchia. On this episode of Spoiler Alert Radio, we speak with Swedish filmmaker Patrick Eklund, who runs his production company Frame Station. Patrick made his directorial